see the amusement and airports over there. So for today, your pilot is Sonal, co-pilot is Pandana, and crew member is Indrani. So over to you, Sonal.
Good evening, guests. So today we'll be visiting the zoo, amusement park, and airports of UAE as told by Indrani. So let's have a look about this country. So UAE or the United Arab Emirates, it's a country in Western Asia, which is located at the eastern end of the Arabian Peninsula. It borders Oman and Saudi Arabia and has a maritime borders in the Persian Gulf with Qatar and Iran. The capital of UAE is Abu Dhabi, which is the second most populous city of the United Arab Emirates after Dubai. The official language of the United Arab Emirates is Arabic. Now let's have a look on the zoo of UAE. So first one is Al Ain Zoo. It has been entertaining and educating animal lovers since it opened in 1968 and features a large collection of local wildlife as well as giraffes, reptiles, and big cats, adding up to 184 different species. Located at the foothills of the Jebel Hafit Mountains, the grounds are huge and the conservation and breeding programs are impressive. Plus, the zoo is open late for those wishing to safari in the dark. The petting zoo has Shetland ponies, rabbits, and the like for little ones to feed. So here you can see the entrance of giraffes, flamingo, and the tiger. Al Tamimi Stables. This is family friendly.
Was the tiger white?
Yes, it was white. So next is Al Tamimi Stables. This is family friendly private farm and education center in these deserts of neighboring Sharjah, which is home to a minigiri of creatures, not just the equestrian kind and features, a petting zoo, as well as a whole host of the other activities. So there are pony rides, falcon displays, sporting facilities, which includes basketball and badminton courts, football fields, and even a recording studio for budding musicians, arts and crafts. Picnic tables, a cafe, and showers provide all the on-site amenities, an action-packed outing meet, and the chance to get up close and personal with plenty of furry friends. Are the animals which are located in that zoo. So you can see deers, the ponies, next come the Atlantis Lost Chambers Aquarium. This aquarium is a maze of tunnels and tanks that are home to 65,000 marine animals with not a whale shark in sight. For a little extra, kids can learn about marine life around them from tour guides and divers, behind the scenes tour and the frenzy of fish feeding.
Ma'am, where is this located?
Sorry?
Where can you find this in UAE?
It's a good question.
We will clear all your doubts after this presentation. Okay.
So here you can see pictures from the Lost Chambers Aquarium. So here are the divers. So this one is Dubai Aquarium and Underwater Zoo. The Dubai Aquarium and Underwater Zoo boasts the Guinness Book of Records largest acrylic panel in the world and the biggest suspended aquarium, which visitors to Dubai Mall can view freely while strolling around the shops. The Underwater Zoo is on three levels and is home to over 140 different species of aquatic animals, plus a few creepy crawlies too. So if you roam around that mall, you can see these aquatic animals. So now we'll have a video here. So now we'll have a look on the amusement park which are present in United Arab Emirates. First one is Warner Bros. World of Abu Dhabi. So welcome to Abu Bros. World, which is in Abu Dhabi, the world's first ever Warner Bros. Branded indoor theme park. As you set foot through the iconic Warner Bros. Shield, prepare to be transported to the lands of your favorite characters for one-of-a-kind immersive experience. So here you can see the cartoon characters. The Scooby-Doo dog, His Honor, and how colorful this theme park is. Next one is Ferrari World Abu Dhabi. So the first Ferrari branded theme park in the world, Ferrari World Abu Dhabi celebrates the passionate spirit of the legendary racing marque. Its iconic structure houses numerous high adrenaline rides featuring the world's fastest roller coaster, family-friendly attraction, state-of-the-art simulators, live shows, and an inspiring treasure of racing memorabilia. Attractions also include two stores and a selection of restaurants that celebrate authentic Italian culinary traditions, making it the place to live the true Ferrari story. So here you can see the rides. The roller coaster. So do you know what Ferrari manufactures?
Sorry. A car?
Yes. What does it manufacture, Ferrari? It manufactures car. So now, next is Yes Water World, which is in Abu Dhabi. A water park with a true Emirati heart. It brings you wave after wave of experiences with over 40 rides, slides, and attractions where every memory counts. So see the ride here. This is the water ride. The background. You can see how big this park is. Now we'll visit a water park.
That python mouth is really looking like a real python's mouth.
Yes. Yeah, I'll be showing the Ferrari world. To go to Ferrari world.
Everywhere.
Yes. So did you see the go-karting track? And the simulator, did you see the rides, roller coaster?
Yes.
So now we'll proceed to the presentation. So Now we'll discover the airports. We'll explore the airports of UAE. Number one is Dubai International Airport. So Dubai International Airport is one of the busiest airports in the world. Since it was first opened in 1960, the airport has seen a yearly growth of greater than 13% in passenger numbers, which now amounts to more than 85 million passengers a year. The airport connects more than 240 destinations in 6 continents with the help of more than 100 airlines. So these are some photos taken from Dubai Airport, Dubai International Airport. Next is Abu Dhabi International Airport. So this is an international airport which is the second largest airport in UAE, but the most luxurious and rapidly developing airport. It connects to over 102 destinations and above 56 countries across the globe. It is well designed with all modern amenities for a comfortable journey. To note, Abu Dhabi International holds a 12 million passenger capacity annually, which is as of 2015. It has certainly increased over the years. It is the hub airbase for Etihad Airways, which is the national airways of UAE. You can see the photos.
That indeed is luxurious.
Great piece of architecture here.
Yeah, that indeed is luxurious.
Yes, it's marvelous. Next comes the Sharjah International Airport, which is located in 13 kilometers southeast of Sharjah city center. It is only international airport serving the city. The airport consists of a single passenger terminal. It is an airbase for Air Arabia, Lufthansa Cargo and Singapore Airlines Cargo. The airport can facilitate about 10 million passengers around the year. Now you can see the dome-shaped architecture here. Next one is Al Batin Executive Airport. This is an exclusive business aviation airport which was the main aviation center until AUH opened in 1982. With the capacity to hold 30 private jets and an ideal fuel stop location, this executive airport is located at the heart of Abu Dhabi and easily accessible to major business hubs, providing world-class facilities like a luxury car from the terminal to aircraft, fast baggage screening, gourmet service, conference rooms, and opulent lounging area and secure parking being the highlights. So here you can see the luxurious cars which will take you from the terminal to your aircraft, your private jet.
Who owns a private jet here?
The sheikhs. People here are so rich.
The picture, yeah, but that one has a plane which looks really beautiful.
This one?
Yes.
Yeah, actually.
It looks different than what we see in India regularly.
Their airplanes are same everywhere, but this is also a photography effect, you can say. So we'll have a look on one of the airports, yeah, in Dubai, in Abu UAE. Over to you, Indrani.
Yeah, thank you, Sonal. So our guest wants to share their experience. So first I would like to call Abhi for sharing his experience.
Okay.
Okay.
So I remember that we went to the aquarium, Dubai Aquarium, the dolphin show, and the water fountain, and the desert.
Oh, that's great. You enjoyed there?
Very much.
Yeah, dolphins are very humble, no?
Yes.
They are very connected to humans. They are so sweet and friendly in nature. Aren't they?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Did you play with them?
No, I did not. I just had to sit back and watch.
That's okay. Because they are inside that boat.
They're inside a dolphinarium.
Okay. So now next we have Abhiruchi. Hi Abhiruchi.
Hi.
So you share your experience over there.
I have in Dubai. In UAE. I only went to Dubai as well. That was the only place I have visited. And in that was the Dubai Mall. There, the aquarium was there. It was like a dome shape, and inside we used that the fishes were all around. And then as we continued inside, there were more sea animals. Like there was an underwater zoo technique.
Okay.
And the Dubai Mall was really fun. It was really fun. Like there was an ice ring inside the mall.
That's great. So we enjoyed a lot there, right?
It was fun.
Yeah.
I remember it clearly because we went in 2019 only March.
Okay, it is a nice place to visit, right?
Yeah, I like it, but it's really hot.
I went in the same year.
What a coincidence.
It's really hot over there, so.
Okay.
There is this desert safari there where they have the shows and there the sand surfing I really like.
Okay. Do you know the national animal of Dubai, UAE?
Yes.
What is it?
Actually, I know it, but I forgot.
Okay. So it's Arabian oryx. We have seen it many times in our presentation. Do you remember it? So Abhi's question was, where is Lost Chamber Aquarium in UAE? Am I right, Abhi?
Yeah, I understood now. It was in Dubai.
It is in Atlantis. Okay.
All right.
Thanks for sharing your experience with us, Abir and Abhiruchi. So tomorrow we are going to visit UK. Can you tell me the full form of UK?
United Kingdom.
Yes. United Kingdom.
Or yes. England.
Yeah, I like to watch videos on the king and the British monarchy history, monarchy of the UK.
Okay. So, task for tomorrow is you have to search about the national symbols of UK. and I will ask you some questions related to that.
National symbols.
Yes, like national flower, national animal, national fruit, and all. Okay?
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So that's all about our today's tour. You enjoyed a lot, right?
I will.
Okay. So meet you tomorrow. Bye. Have a great day.